Dear students of class 9th, today's topic is unit 3, Qaid, a great leader. Iski Urdu translation hai, Qaid, ek azim rehnuma. Now this lesson is about Qaid-e-Azam's arrival to Karachi immediately after Pakistan came into being. I'll start reading from page number 25. It was August 7th, 1947, when a silver aircraft circled over the airport at Maripur, Karachi. It was watched by a vast, excited crowd while smoothly landing. First to step out of the aeroplane was a tall and dignified man wearing a pure white sherwani. As soon as he appeared, the whole crowd roared with one voice, "Pakistan Zindabad, Pakistan Zindabad," and everyone pushed forward to welcome him, to get as close to him as possible in order to see him clearly. For here was their great leader, Qaid-e-Azam, the founder and first Governor General of their new country. Here was their leader who had won Pakistan for them, Muhammad Ali Jinnah. As he drove through the great sea of people that stretched from the airport to the city, through all the cheers and tears of joy and the never-ending slogans of Pakistan Zindabad, the Qaid showed no signs of his feelings. He rarely did. If he felt pride or joy in what he had done, he did not let anybody see it. Through all the excitement of those first days in the life of the young nation, the man who had made it possible remained calm, serious and sober. Perhaps he was thinking of the millions of people who had become homeless when India and Pakistan became separate countries. Perhaps he was thinking of the thousands who were being attacked and killed on the roads and railways as they tried to reach their homeland. There was much in those days of violence to sadden Jinnah, who was a man of very strong feelings, although he rarely showed it. Yet those who were close to him on Independence Day sometimes saw for a few moments a happier man. Once he went to the balcony of the Governor House, from where he could see without being seen. And as he looked on, the crowd still cheering in the streets outside, he smiled. In that smile could be seen the warm-hearted man behind the stern Qaid-e-Azam. Muhammad Ali Jinnah was at this time tired and far from well, but he had the satisfaction of knowing that the greater part of his work was done. By the force of his determination and leadership, a people who had once been a defeated group with little to hope for in an empire ruled by a foreign power, had become the greatest of the Muslim states and the fifth largest nation in the world. 70 million people who once had no country to call their own had become a nation. With great ideals and a great faith, a few days after he landed in Karachi, Muhammad Ali Jinnah told his people, "You are free to go to your temples, you are free to go to your mosques or to any other place of worship in this state of Pakistan. You may belong to any religion or caste. We are all citizens of one state." He was, of course, reminding them of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's teachings that all men are equal in the eyes of Allah. Now I am giving you words and meanings. Dignified, calm and serious and deserving respect. Empire, a group of countries or states that are controlled by one ruler or government. Stern, serious and often disapproving, expecting somebody to obey you. Stretched, being longer. Slogan, a word or phrase that is easy to remember, used, for example, by a political party or in advertising to attract people's attention or to suggest an idea quickly. Vast, extremely large in area, size, amount. Cheering, loud shouting that shows support, praise or encouragement for somebody. Foreign, in or from a country that is not your own. Leadership, the state or position of being a person who leads a group of people, especially the head of a country or an organization. Homeless, people who have no home. Excitement, a feeling of great enthusiasm and eagerness. Refuge, the state of being safe or sheltered. Violence, behavior involving physical force intended to hurt or damage. Determination, firmness of purpose.